How's everyone doing today? Today's Sunday, Valentine's Day, so this video is going to be very short. I just wanted to make this video to see how fast I can get all six shots with the Steamboat AR6. I do have my stopwatch here. I haven't started it yet. I actually have to load this real quick. But I did want to have a quick conversation. Because a couple people have some questions about this right here. You won't be able to use a scope per se. That's why I have the red dot sight. Because I don't know if you ever seen the AR6, but you load it right through here. So if you put the scope, a long scope, that right on top, you won't be able to open this door. That's why I went with the reflex sight, because it's short enough. It's short enough to where it won't get in the way of me loading this. The AR6. So, I'm just gonna load this real quick. Okay, we got our six shots in there. Okay. Oh, and by the way, this is a new string. I haven't used it yet. I did get the old string, the one that I took out. I did have it reserved. I got the serving string yesterday in the mail, and I did reserve them. Like, I did fix the serving string. This is the serving string right here, for those that don't know. From here to here, it's called the center serving string, and I did replace that one. I did it myself. Because the bowstring itself was in very good condition, so I just had it re I just reserved it myself, with the serving string and a serving jig, and it came out very good. So, like I said, if the center serving gets messed up, if you forget to wax it for any reason, lube the rail, wax the string. If you forget to wax the center serving and it starts to fray a little bit, there's no reason to get a new one. You just buy the you get 100 yards and a spool with the serving jig, and you just reserve it, and you can get it done in less than 10 minutes. So, that's what I did. I bought the extra string just in case. But yeah, I reserved mines, both of them, yesterday, and they came out pretty good. So that's that. Okay, so I'm gonna start my timer. Now, I'm not looking for accuracy. I am gonna try to get it into, if you see that target right there, the bottom target right there, I am gonna try to get it in there on that target, but I'm not looking to hit the center per se. I'm just looking to get it on target. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to get it all on target, but I am gonna try. Okay. So, I'm gonna start my timer, and obviously, it's gonna take me about a second to load it, because I'm not loading it. I'm not cocking it yet. I wanna start fresh. Like, if I just grabbed it from my nightstand or from wherever I have it and cocked it to per se defend myself. Okay? So I'm starting the timer now in 1, 2, 3. Okay. And we are starting. One more. Oh, nope, I got one more. Sorry about that. And I'm done. Okay. So, with all the with the little bit of time, it took me 28 seconds. If you take 1 second or two off for the beginning, because I had to stand up, so it roughly took me 25 seconds to send six shots downrange. 25 seconds. Now, I'm pretty sure with practice, I can get it probably down to about 15, 20, give or take. So that's how come I say that it is possible for you to use these. I'm going to take to use these right here, these AR-6s, for self-defense. Now, is it better than having a boomstick? As my buddy over at Prepper Nation says, no, it is not better than a boomstick. Pardon the mess over here. This is the room that I am fixing. But as you can see, they're all on target. And the grouping, as you can see, is about the size of my palm. Because these targets are pretty small. Let me show you. There you go. That's the target. And I have pretty small hands. So it is very, very accurate. So as you can see, all of them are there. And I can cover all of them with my palm. So grouping is very, very good. And I wasn't even trying to for accuracy. And for, like I said, about 25 seconds, it's not bad. You know, you can, with enough practice, you can do better. You can shave that down to, like I said, about 15 to 20 seconds with enough practice. So, yeah. Now, as I always say, when you're practicing, when you're target shooting, always have these rails lubed and the string. Now, obviously, in a self-defense situation, you're not going to care about the string. You're not going to care about lubing your rail, and I wouldn't either. I would care less about the string. I would burn the string out if I have to. You know, but it is, you can use these if you need to. You know, if you can't get your hands on a boomstick, you know, with some freedom seeds, get yourself one of these. And again, these are for lethal self-defense measures. This isn't for a less lethal self-defense measure. This is for a lethal self-defense measure. Get yourself one of these. You don't need no background checks needed. You know, you pay for it, you get it to your house. That's what it is. Now, I am going to say, use these responsibly. You know, don't go out there trying to cause trouble. Know your state and local laws on these. I know here in the state that I'm in, it is perfectly legal to own these. No permits, no nothing required. Obviously, you have to be over 18, and that's about it. So please use these responsibly. If you decide to get one of these, use them responsibly. And as I mentioned before in one of my other videos, I did purchase two of the Cobra Adders with the V2 magazines from GoGun.co. I am just waiting for the shipment to be shipped out. It's supposed to be shipping out next time, sometime next month. So hopefully we get it in sometime in March, and I can do some reviews on that and show you guys what that could do. Obviously, that one is this one's big brother. It's gonna have more power. It's gonna have one arrow more than this one. This one holds six. The V2 Cobra Adder with the V2 magazine holds seven bolts, and it is a lot more powerful than this one. This one with those bolts are 8 grams, roughly 140 grain, shoots roughly 190 feet per second. So it's about roughly 11 to 12 foot pounds of energy. Now, I know it doesn't sound like a lot of energy, but those bolts are very, very sharp. Now, I'm going to try to get one of these out of here. These bolts are very, very sharp. I am going to say that. Now, this is a target bolt, but it is very sharp. Now, I have hunting ones upstairs that are a lot more expensive than this one. I just use these for targets because they're cheap. But I do have some hunting bolts upstairs, and they'll do some damage. Now, as I said before, I'm not saying this one won't cause any damage, because I'm pretty sure if you catch someone with this, it'll cause some damage. You know, it is very sharp. I will say that. So you please use these responsibly. As I said again, thanks for watching. If you like these videos, like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Have yourselves a good day.